Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn tips, tricks, and shortcuts in 7 minutes or less. No BS, just AE.
Matt. Set Matt is a fast and convenient way to hide and reveal content. There are other ways to do this same process, but Set Matt reduces the number of layers in your project and also makes the boundaries for revealing and hiding content more precise. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so let's bring in a solid, and I'm going to show you a way to hide and reveal content using alpha mats. Bring in this solid. Let's change the scale. We can unlink this, make it about that size. And now I'm just going to focus on this Jeff Knight text right here. Okay, so if I want this text only to show up in this area, what I'll do is go over to my track mat and change it from none to alpha mat. And now it shows up within this boundary here. And notice how After Effects automatically hides your solid layer. And if you move the text around, you can see the effect. The problem comes in whenever you have multiple layers. So say if I wanted to do the same thing for these other layers of text, I would have to duplicate this solid and then set these track modes also to alpha. So now they would only show up within this boundary. This could really clog up your project file. Right now we have 6 layers total for these 3 lines of text and for this effect. So let's change this all back to no track mat and we'll get rid of these solid layers. And the best way to do this is with a shape layer. So let's go to layer, new shape layer, and then we want to add a rectangle and give it a fill. The thing that's cool about shape layers is that the size setting within your rectangle path is in pixels, not percentages. And the reason why that's important is, say you have a very specific area that you want to act as a mat. And if you have the exact dimensions, you can put that in here. So if you type 1920, we'll see that it stretches the entire width of our screen, and 1080 stretches the height. So we're not going to go quite that high, but say, let's leave this to 1920 and bring it down about where we had our solid. Highlight Jeff Knight. Let's go over to our effects and presets and type in set mat. With Jeff Knight highlighted, just double click on the set mat. And we see that it's in our effect control panel. So if we go up here, take mat from, let's set it to shape layer 1. Now if we hide our shape layer, and we'll hide these other lines of text, bring up our position, we can see that this is working. And one of the options that you have that's kind of cool is this invert mat, which basically works as an alpha invert mat. So now this text will show up in every area other than where our shape layer is located. Let's take off invert mat, copy this effect, and all we have to do is apply it to our other layers of text. So control V. All of these are using that one mat as an alpha mat. So see, our 7-minute AE tutorials is affected. And our power of shape layers is affected, and our Jeff Knight is affected. So whereas before we had 6 layers for these 3 lines of text, now we only have 4. So it's just one additional layer. Set Matt only works on rasterized layers. Shape layers and text layers are automatically rasterized by After Effects. Things that are not automatically rasterized are solids, images, and video. Let's see the same effect with the solid. Take off that shape layer, and then let's just bring a solid back in. Bring up our scale, and I'm going to do the same thing I did last time, make it about right here. On this Jeff Knight layer, let's go back up to our effects and controls, and we want to change this to our solid. Let's hide these 2 layers of text so we can focus on 1 line of text. So now if we hide this solid, we'll see that Jeff Knight is not being affected at all by this set mat. If you highlight solid and then you rasterize it by clicking this icon here, now the solid is rasterized, so now it does work. So you can use a solid. Why I like to use shape layers is because shape layers are measured in pixels, not in percentages. Shape layers are automatically rasterized and they're just much more precise. Okay, so now let's go through some of these other settings. Right now we have this set to source. Let's see what this mask setting has. I'm going to actually add back in my shape layer for this part. There are a few things I want to go over that are specific to shape layers. So add in the shape layer, do our rectangle, add our fill, and then I'm just going to bring this out and bring it up. And then let's set our set mat back to our shape layer. I'll go ahead and do that for these other 2 layers, so that way we already have it ready to go. As we can see, it is being affected by this shape layer. What if we didn't want this hard edge? Maybe we wanted it to be a softer edge. Turn back on your shape layer. You can grab your shape creation tool. This defaults to this setting, tool create shape. So if I start to try to mask it, it's just going to make another shape. So there's a setting right next to it, tool creates mask. So let's click that, and now this will work as a mask. So now let's just mask out an area of this shape layer. F for feather, and we're going to feather the edges. Now let's turn the shape layer back off. And as you can see right now, we still have that hard edge. The reason why is because set mat is set only to source. Hit masks. Now it will recognize that feather. There's also one more setting, masks and effects. So with the shape layer highlighted, let's look for roughen edge. Double click that on. Maybe we'll increase this feather a little bit. Let's turn off our shape layer. And now under set mat, let's leave it at mask for right now. And as you can see, we have that feather still, but we're not really seeing this effect of the roughen edge. If you choose this other option, effects and masks, now it will recognize that roughen edge. Let's go ahead and copy this, and I'll just override these other layers. But say we don't want this text layer to recognize the effects. We'll just take that off and change it to masks. And so now this layer will only recognize masks, while this one will recognize effects and masks. And for the other text layer, we can have this where it only recognizes source. So you have all of these options that you can do with this one effect. And again, this is all being controlled on one layer, a shape layer. If you use a solid, make sure that you rasterize it. Let's see how this will work with images. Go ahead and take off this mask and this effect. I'm going to hide these text layers, and then let's bring in this skies image here. Set mat, double click, take mat from layer, shape layer, and then let's hide our shape layer so that way we can see what the effect is going to be. If we start to move around our image right now, watch what happens. It's pulling the shape of the mat with it, but it's not interacting with it. One option is to pre-comp it. So Control Shift C. And now you have two options, leave all attributes or move all attributes. If you leave all attributes, the pre-comp will become the source of the layer. Hit OK. And now we have this option for rasterize. So let's click the rasterize button. Now, if we move our position, we can see that it's interacting the same way that our text layer did, where it's only revealing the image within that matte area. I'm going to undo this so we don't have a pre-comp. Pre-comp it again. So Control Shift C. And now this time I'm going to move all attributes. It moves all the properties of this image into another composition. So we hit OK. We can still rasterize this layer now. But now watch, if we move our position, it's acting the same way it did before. So I'm going to undo that again. Control Shift C and leave all attributes. As long as you leave all the attributes, this will be effective for using set mat.
I hope that helped you out. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe. I've put a link to the project file in the description below, and I'd love to get your feedback about this lesson. Reach out to me on Facebook, YouTube, or shoot me an email anytime with your suggestions for any topic you'd like to see covered, or just to talk about motion graphic design in general. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you next time.